after much controversy, the Philippines pushes through with its sugar importation plan. The Sugar Regulatory Administration formally authorized the importation of 150,000 metric tons of refined sugar. Under the order, the imported sugar must arrive in the Philippines on or before November 15. Half of it will be used for industrial use, while the other half will be for consumers. Sugar importation has been a hot topic after a botched plan to import 300,000 metric tons of the commodity led to congressional investigations and resignations of SRA officials. The SRA also issues an order allocating all locally produced sugar for domestic consumption. Sugar Order Number 1 covers the current crop year, which will last until the end of August 2023. 1.8 million metric tons of raw sugar are expected to be produced during this period. The order was signed by Philippine President and Agriculture Secretary Ferdinand Marcos Jr., Agriculture Undersecretary Domingo Panganiban, and three SRA officials, including Acting Administrator David Tadeos Alba. The SRA is in charge of classifying locally produced sugar for U.S. quota, for domestic consumption, for reserve, or for the world market. The Senate minority defends its move to release a separate report about the sugar importation fiasco. Its leader, Senator Coco Pimentel, says they disagree with the findings of the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee. In their report, Senators Pimentel and Risa Ontiveros said the signatories of a botched sugar importation plan acted in good faith. They also contradicted the Senate panel's decision to clear Executive Secretary Vic Rodriguez from the controversy.
Linagay namin yung sarili namin sa sitwasyon ng apat eh. Tamatan nila, number one, urgent yung sugar crisis eh. Taas ng presyo ng asukal, may hawak silang datos, kita naman nila talaga mayroong shortage. Tapos sinabihan din naman sila na urgent, tapos nagbibigay naman sila ng update doon sa Malacanang, sa Office of the Executive Secretary, na-update naman nila ng mabuti. So para sa amin, may good faith eh. Kung mayroong good faith, at medyo pumutok yung issue dahil sa miscommunication o kulang sa koordinasyon, eh wag na tayong magpalusot na eh kasuhan niya mga yan, mga anti-graft, kasuhan niya mga yan. Meron pang kinapakaso na smuggling, alam ba natin na non-billable yun, ganun kabigat yun ha.
The former head of the Sugar Regulatory Administration welcomes the Senate Minority Report on the Sugar Probe. Hermenegildo Serafica thanks Senators Pimentel and Ontiveros, saying they clearly see the data and the evidence he submitted in his defense. He insists he and the other sugar regulatory officials were only doing their duties and had done nothing wrong. Turning now to the budget deliberations at the lower house, lawmakers terminate the hearing for the Office of the Vice President's proposed 2.3 billion peso budget for next year in minutes. The OVP's spending plan is 223% higher than the 709 million peso budget of the office this year. The House Panel on Appropriations did not entertain any questions as a courtesy to Vice President Sara Duterte, who was personally present during the hearing.
Thank you for sharing this day with the Office of the Vice President. And thank you for your continued support to the budget and all the programs, activities, and projects of the Office of the Vice President. And if there is anything that we can do to help you as an office in your respective mandates, in your respective legislative districts and party lists, please do let us know. We are open to collaborations in helping our fellow Filipinos.
The swift termination of budget hearings for the Office of the President and OVP is normal as courtesy for both offices. Lawmakers will just have to ask their questions during plenary deliberations.